हम्प्टी शर्मा बैठा एक दीवार पे, हम्प्टी शर्मा गिर गया काव्या के प्यार में, लेकिन उनके बीच में थे बाबूजी, अंटिल ही सेड जा जी ले अपनी जिंदगी। हाय गाइस, वेलकम टू द 10 का 20 मूवी रिव्यू शो। आई जस्ट गॉट बैक फ्रॉम हम्प्टी शर्मा की दुल्हन या फर्स्ट डे फर्स्ट शो, एंड इट्स बेसिकली ट्रिब्यूट टू DDLJ। जस्ट लाइक माई पोएम इन द बिगनिंग ऑफ द शो वॉज अ ट्रिब्यूट टू DDLJ, दिस मूवी एंड द नर्सरी राइम हम्प्टी डम्प्टी। सो आई गेस इंस्टेड ऑफ ट्रिब्यूट आई शुड कॉल इट अ थ्री ब्यूट, गेट इट? I've also realized that people with mustaches should not be reciting nursery rhymes as it might be very creepy. So in case I've traumatized you, I apologize. So the filmmakers are actually very conscious of the fact that they're making a tribute to probably the biggest Bollywood romantic film in recent times. It's actually not that recent anymore. It's almost 20 years old. Are you feeling old? I'm feeling old. So overall, I thought it was a fairly good adaptation, if you can call it that. Like, of course, instead of Switzerland, you had Delhi, which was, well, different, and that's actually good, right? And I really love the Delhi part. The first half of the movie was set in Delhi and DU, and nice Delhi lines and dialogues like "Madam, ye 100% original fake hai ji." And the second half, which was based in Ambala, had more of the romantic stuff and the issues, and where it got a bit serious at times, but never too serious. So it like still was had lots of nice one-liners and generally the characters doing random stuff. They played on some of the iconic scenes, the train thing and the whole "Ja ji le apni zindagi" and all that. So and they did their own thing, and I thought it was a very good tribute. Coming to the acting, I thought Varun Dhawan was really good. His character was well written, and I think he had enough different things to do. Alia Bhatt's character was a bit unidimensional in a way. Like, she was just whining most of the time and trying to be a badass, but she did her job very well. And guess who's back? Ashutosh Rana is back, and he's the Babuji. Of course, he's not an Amrish Puri, but I think he does a pretty decent job. My favorite character was Poplu, who was like the hero's sidekick friend person. I mean, fairly consistent, and he was really funny. The songs are fairly decent, and you don't mind them in the movie, except for the one Punjabi wedding song in which they all like narrate their like own love stories, and it was pretty weird. From the BG to the parents to the sister, that was a bit weird and lame and random. Otherwise, generally the songs are nice. Of course, not DDLJ kind of songs. Satyajit Ray was drinking with his friends, and then he suddenly like "Zara sa jhoom loo main," and they were like "Na re na re na." So I'm not exactly a fan of rom-com movies, though I didn't mind this movie that much. Like, I was fairly entertained. I didn't get bored, even though the movie was about 2 hours and 15 minutes long. But I'm sure if you're a fan of rom-coms, you would enjoy this movie. I paid 130 rupees for this movie, and I actually didn't mind paying that money for this movie. 50 rupees would go probably for the acting of the main lead, 20 rupees for Ashutosh Rana's comeback, 20 rupees for Poplu, 30 rupees for the song, and maybe another 30 to 40 rupees for pulling off a fairly decent tribute, in my opinion. I'm not too sure how die-hard DDLJ fans will react to this movie, but if you generally like rom-coms, you can add probably another 50 rupees to the whole total. What's your favorite, tribute movie, especially in Bollywood? I can't think of any examples right now, but do leave a comment below telling me what your favorite movie is, and also let me know what you think about this review and the movie if you end up watching it. And also like the video and share the video, subscribe to the channel, and follow us on Facebook and Twitter so that you don't miss the next 10 ka 20 movie review, and I'll see you next Friday. Thank you for watching. Ja jile apni zindagi.